Good evening. We're so pleased to have you join us for this commencement evening concert that is also our send-off for spring tour. I'm so excited to be headed to the Southwest because that's an area that we have never traveled, or that I have never personally traveled to with the choir before. And I'm so excited to connect with congregations in Albuquerque and in Phoenix and Tucson. We're going to spend a weekend in LA and then swing through Denver on our way back. So this is one of the best times to travel because we leave on Monday. And when I take all the students with me on the bus, nobody brings homework along. I am so thankful in our department to Karen Unruh, who's done all of the planning for this trip. Without her, it would not happen. Ken and I sit down with her in a meeting and say, what if we did this and what if we did that? And then she makes everything happen. So let's give her a round of applause. Tonight's concert follows our theme verse for the year, which is printed on the top of the program, listing all of our pieces of music. And throughout the program, you can find the text of our songs. I hope you follow through and engage not only with the music, but also with the text as we sing in this time of music making and worship as we bring this whole year to a close and send ourselves out into the world on our tour. And for some of these students, this is their last time singing as a student in this space. So I'm so happy for you to join us, and I hope that you enjoy this performance.
As the flood.
One of the neat things about our department is that we do a lot of collaboration together. And on this trip, I'm so excited because Holly Schwarzendruber, our voice professor, is going to be traveling with us. We're going to have a little section of interludes, and many of the pieces that you're going to hear are pieces that students have done in their voice lessons with Holly. And then she is going to end the interlude section for us and join us for a few pieces in the second half. So we'll take a little break with the choir and let you hear some of our solo pieces that we've been working on this year.
Hi, I'm Eli Stoll. I'm going to be singing Zweignon by Richard Strauss. Test toiles helle, das im Fern von dir mich quelle. Liebe macht die Herzen krank. Habe Dank. Eins hielt ich der Freiheit säge, auch den Test in Becken und zu segnen testen trank, aber Dank. Und beschloss darin die Bösen, bis ich, was ich nie gewesen.
This is a test to see if I can operate this mic stand. I'll just talk like this. So the next piece is written by me. It's part of a larger song, but I condensed it down for piano, and my good friend Ken agreed to play it. It's called Heavenly Sunrise. I like it a lot, and I hope you do too. Thank you. Name is Jack Shingler, by the way. Thank you very much.
My name is Luke Hoyard, and I'm going to be singing Bring Him Home from Les Miserables.
Fun fact, if you watch the teacher of the students singing, they're usually breathing with the students, because that helps them, obviously, right? This evening, I'll be singing a song written by a 20th century African-American composer named Undine Smith Moore. The song is Come Down Angels.
Come down. forsake me, I'm in her hand. She sets a table before me in the presence of my foes. She anoints my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely, surely goodness and kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will live in her house forever, forever and ever. Glory be to our mother and daughter and to the Holy of Holies, as it was in the beginning, is now,
sinking down.
If you notice in the program, Bobby McFerrin wrote that 23rd Psalm piece at a dedication to his mother, which I think is perfect for us to be singing on Mother's Day weekend. And there's a very special mother in my family who is right in the front pew over there. So I am so grateful to my family. And I love working at Hesston College because it's a place where my faith and my love for music intersect. I love working with the colleagues in my department. I'm so thankful for the support that we get from Dr. Moom in academics, and it's pretty cool to be a music department with a boss that is a professional singer. We get a lot of support that way, and I appreciate that. This is a place that really invests in the lives of students, and I think if I think back to my time in college, it's really some of the experiences that you get that really last with you for a lifetime. And How many of you in the audience are Bel Canto alumni? There's a bunch of you out there. And we are so excited about next year, because next year Bel Canto is having a birthday. We're going to turn 40. And so if you notice in the program, there's a little blurb about next year homecoming. We want to invite all Bel Canto singers to come back. And next year is Ken Rogers' 20th trip across the ocean to Europe. And so we're inviting all alumni to come back and have an alumni choral tour with us that goes to Europe. While we're there, we're going to celebrate the 200th birthday of the church building of Yaura, church congregation that we have traveled to every single year that Ken Rogers has been in the choir, ever since he was their age. It's been a while. Ken and I are already reserving our rooms at the villa next to each other, so that's how it goes. Now is the time for us to have a moment of reflection of our gifts and just be thankful for what we get at the college, all the music and how important that is to us. If you're able, we appreciate if you can make a donation, that the money all goes directly to support our travel costs. We also have a way for you to give online. There's a little website in the bulletin that you can do a credit card donation. If you make the donation go to Bel Canto Singers, that will go into our offering tonight. So please bow with me in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this place. This place where students come from all over the country and all over the world. And they find faith here, and they find music here, they find friends here, and that lasts for them a lifetime. I'm so grateful to be a part of that journey, and I'm so grateful to see so many people who are back in this place again, who have been part of that journey for so long. Thank you so much for all the gifts that you give us, and bless our tour, bless our safety, and bless this music that we get to make together. Amen.
Seeing A Million Dreams from the Greatest Showman. Thank you.
sounds crazy.
One foot in front of the other, and lead with love.
Thank you again for joining us this evening. As part of the commencement weekend activities, there is a reception in Krupp Center that is happening following this event for the business department. How many of you are graduating as a business major tomorrow? Yeah. This also, let's give it a round of applause. This also sets a new record for Bel Canto singers because we have students that have sung for 8 semesters in Bel Canto, which is awesome for me because I get to know them even better throughout those years. And some of these students also have gone through an amazing time of COVID, and we almost forget what that was unless it just kind of pops up in your backyard again. But I was looking back on the program from last year just to kind of check my tour formatting, and we had on the program, audience requires a mass. And I remember planning that spring break tour in January when Omicron was happening, and we didn't know if that tour was going to happen. And then as we were getting ready for that trip to happen, our hosts in Europe said, "Are you coming?" And we said, "Can we come?" And they said, "Sure." And so we all bought our plane tickets really fast. And so I just think of these students up here have been so resilient, and they have really bonded together. One thing about these students is that they have taken care of each other more deeply than any other class that I've had in the past. And so I've really enjoyed working with you. How many of you is this your last concert on stage as a student? Let's give them a round of applause. But they haven't graduated yet because they're still in my class. And we're singing tomorrow. Thank you again so much for joining us. We'll give you one last blessing before we depart.